Welcome back to another day of judging here at EKKA. It is day 5 and today we are looking at group 5. We have Collie Ruff still in the ring for just another few moments and then we'll be crossing to watch the group specials for the working group today. We'll be back tomorrow as well with lots more breeds, but in just a few moments, those working breeds. We've got a bit of a quieter day as far as people walking around at EKKA today for day 5, but we have a great audience getting ready for group specials for the working dogs today, which is lovely to see. Everyone's finding a seat and ready to see some beautiful dogs.
Lovely to see you officiating here.
Group 5 judge, Mr. Gerard Yipping from the Netherlands, has returned after a short break and we're ready to get started on the group judging for the working dogs group. Now there, as every day, have been a number of breeds that our judge hasn't seen today. These best of breeds were awarded today by Mr. Weng Wo Chan from Malaysia. We'll start off with the Australian cattle dog, also known as the Australian heeler, or sometimes the Queensland heeler, or maybe more commonly, the blue heeler. They are registered on the ANKC as Australian cattle dogs. This one, our best of breed earlier today. Judge sending him around, it appears, in a triangle, which is a bit different from what our judges in previous days have asked for, which has been the out and back to start with. The triangle giving them the away movement towards and the side movement view as well. So a great tool used by judges to consider the movement of the dogs. First handler for the group judging, just checking where he needs to go. As the Australian cattle dog makes his way out of the ring, Mr. Yipping turns his attention to the Australian kelpie. It's a fantastic contingent of Australian developed breeds here, the Australian kelpie. Developed because a lot of the European sheepdogs just had coats that just made it too hot, too hard to deal with the harsh Australian climate. So the need for the beautiful and very recognisable Australian kelpie occurred. Ooh. Coming back, the audience enjoying the sight of the popular Australian kelpie. Judge sending the kelpie out to the end as he turns his attention to the next dog, the Australian Shepherd. That's interesting. This is something I didn't know about the Aussie Shepherds, is they actually come naturally with a range of tail lengths due to a natural bobbing gene. So you might see them with the natural bob tail, you could see them with a full feathered tail. This one with the natural bobtail. Australian Shepherd ready to head around in a triangle as the judge considers the movement of the dog away, the side profile movement, and back towards it. As with all our working breeds, that movement all just looks effortless, doesn't it? Some exuberance, there's a lot of excitement from both handlers and dogs at Royals. As the Australian Shepherd makes her way out to the back gate, and the judge turns his attention to the bearded collie. Bearded collie, one of the more heavily coated breeds in the working group. They go back to sheep farmers to work rugged mountain areas of the Scottish Highlands. So need to be rugged in a different way, need to be able to stay warm. But still a working breed and still effortless on the move. Bearded collie heading around to the end. A border collie, the next breed. Remembering, of course, these best of breeds were awarded by the judge's Malaysian counterpart earlier today. It was a very strong entry contingent border collies. Border collie, probably one of the most recognizable breeds. Dr. Harry has border collies. If you're a 90s kid like me and remember watching Harry's Practice back in the day. I can't remember what his border collie's name was though. Border collie heading around to the end, and the judge turning his attention to the beautiful Briard. Briard, an ancient breed, and not ones that you see as often these days. I remember seeing lots of them as a kid, but it's very exciting to see beautiful Briards exhibited at the Royals. A lot of work goes into those beautiful flowing coats with the Briard and with any coated breed. You can trace the Briards back as far as Charlemagne, as the breeders will tell you.
Now, as we explained, each of the breeds has
sending the Briard around to the end, which draws to a close the breeds that this judge hasn't awarded. We're going to kick it off. Our first breed, the Belgian Shepherd Gronendal. The next Belgian Shepherd, Malinois.
These are all our best breed wins for today.
The Belgian Shepherd Terouven.
The White Swiss Shepherd.
The White Swiss Shepherd as well. The Welsh Corgi Pembroke waiting in the wings.
The Welsh Corgi Pembroke.
Very popular among the audience today. The Welsh Corgi Cardigan. Coming along behind. Judge having a good look at the cardigan.
Swedish Valhund.
Swedish Valhund coming through. With the Shetland Sheepdog. Waiting. And now going around.
The Pumi.
Some oohs and ahs from the audience.
The beautiful Pumi.
The Puli. With a very recognisable dreadlocked coat. And the old English sheepdog. Ready for his hearing. Made famous by Dulux paints, I believe. No, for more than that. But the audience recognising a lovely breed as the GSD or German Shepherd Dog goes around.
German Shepherd LSC.
And the long stock coat, German Shepherd.
Finnish Lapland.
And the Collie Ruff.
Waiting.
The last of the breeds awarded by this judge, Mr. Yipping from the Netherlands, as the ones he's just examined go around, starting with the Australian Cattle Dog, the Australian Kelpie behind, the Australian Shepherd.
Australian Shepherd.
The Bearded Collie. Also getting a cheer and a round of applause from the audience, as have all the breeds.
Border Collie.
And the Briard at the very end to finish up our best of breeds for Working Dog Group 5 today.
All these wonderful best of breeds from our Working Group today.
The judge taking a walk down the line as the audience shows their appreciation for a beautiful lineup of dogs. Past the Belgian Shepherd varieties to the White Swiss. Our Corgis as well. Pembroke and Cardigan. not to be confused with the Swedish Valhund. And the Sheltie, the Pumi, and the Pooley. Pooley had his photo taken by the Courier Mail today, so we'll have to watch the newspapers. Plus the Old English Sheepdog and the German Shepherd varieties. The Finnish Lapland. The Collie Ruff. Down past our wonderful Australian breeds, we're very proud of. Australian Cattle Dog, Kelpie, Shepherd. The Bearded Collie, Border Collie, and Briard at the end. The judge, not looking at all convinced, actually. I think it's a very difficult decision for him today. He's looking up and down the line, up and down, not giving away any clues as to who he might be awarding the very coveted besting group today. It looks to me like he's telling the steward he wants to pick all of them. Stamping his foot almost. Very difficult decision, a beautiful lineup of best of breeds.
Besting group, so our second place getter from the breed will come back in now. Ribbon in hand, we're waiting.
Oh, he's teasing us, heading down towards the German Shepherds and then changing his mind, coming back up the line. The Belgian varieties. This is the one I stumble over every time, Tavurin, Belgian Shepherd Tavurin. Please be more than welcome to correct me if I've stumbled over that so many times. We'll need the runner-up best of breed, Belgian Shepherd Tavurin, to come back in. And as we have seen already in EKKA, that dog equally as likely as any of the others to be awarded the runner-up or reserve besting group. We're doing a really quick change of handler. The same handler must have both the best of breed and runner-up best of breed. It's doing a quick shuffle. Now the judge did award the runner-up best of breed as well today. So won't need to examine.
So here's our runner-up coming back in.
Joel?
So congratulations to our runner-up.
Probably just send it around and pop it back into the space.
Be eligible for reserve in group.
As lovely judge from the Netherlands considers who to award the runner-up or reserve in group. Heading back down towards the Shepherds. But he teased me before, didn't he? Turning to Australian breeds. And the Australian Cattle Dog is our runner-up besting group. He's a showman, our judge, today, isn't he? He's teasing us. Definitely enjoying his day, as we're enjoying his judging. Round of applause from the judge and the audience for our best and runner-up in group. The judge now ready to consider the best of breed puppies. I should say best puppies of breed. Turn that around. Best puppies of breed. He had a number of breeds, of course, that he did not award best puppy, so he'll need to examine those dogs before moving on to award them.
All the puppies should be ready, please. Puppies ready to come into the ring.
Here the ring stewards or the marshalling stewards hustling up the puppies. There will be a lot of handlers that need to switch over dogs. Maybe waiting on a Australian cattle dog puppy. Well, they may not be a AustralianCattle.puppy.
Australian Shepherd joining us. So our first dog there.
Alright. Our first dog to be examined. Switching numbers around. They're a little bit out of order, but that's okay. Judge examining the puppy. And sending around the Australian Shepherd puppy. There are lots of wonderful smells for a working dog on the ground by day five. Lots of distractions. That's okay. The Australian Shepherd puppy. Australian cattle dog has been located. It is confusing. Remember too, in a normal championship show, we'd go straight into the baby puppy class. But for the Royal, we're going straight into puppy class, which can be confusing. There's a lot of activity and a lot of noise in the marshalling area. So it's actually exceptionally easy mistake to make. As the cattle dog puppy makes its way back to the judge, should call it by its full name, the Australian cattle dog, sometimes known as a blue heeler. Strong connections to Queenslanders, that's for sure. Getting a clap as he goes around. The bearded collie puppy, the next for consideration. Judge having a good feel of that construction down the top line, having a feel of the hips down the turn of stifle, the undercarriage, the tail, everything. And sending the bearded collie puppy, aged somewhere between 6 and 12 months. Around in a triangle. All of the wonderful smells are very distracting for working dogs. Remember how busy and active these dogs are. That's natural. That's what we want, in fact. And moving your attention to the border collie puppy. Good feel of the border collie puppy's shoulder, down the top line and hips, feeling that tail, and the powerful muscling, maybe not as powerful in a puppy as in an adult, but still wanting to feel it there. The border collie very popular as well, as he goes around in a triangle. There is a very busy audience too. Is something that a lot of these puppies have never experienced anything like it. Border collie puppy probably resisting the urge to round up all the kids. Good look from the judge. Looks as though that might have finished up the puppies that were awarded by a Malaysian judge. So we're going around in catalogue order rather than alphabetical order, starting with our Belgian Shepherd dog, Vernendal. The Belgian Shepherd dog, Tavern. Puppy. White Swiss Shepherd puppy. With the Welsh Corgi Pembroke, ready to go. The Swedish Valhund puppy. Valhund puppy in the background, ready to go. Valhund looking very proud, not fazed by the audience. Shetland Sheepdog puppy going around. Of course, awarded earlier today, Best Puppy by this judge, our old English Sheepdog puppy. And our German Shepherd puppies ready in the wings. That was the long stock coat variety, with the Finnish Lapland behind, making a bit of a smaller circle. Don't cover as much ground as the German Shepherds. Legs a littler. The Collie Rough puppy. And the Australian Cattle Dog puppy, ready to move. The Australian Shepherd puppy, waiting and ready to go. The bearded collie. The border collie puppy.
The border collie.
Which I think, yes, that rounds us out as the last breed to be considered for best puppy in the show.
Puppies, so please, big round of applause for all our puppies.
Best puppy in group, the best puppy in group will return to be considered for best puppy in show on Saturday. It will be day 8 of EKKA. Judge making his way down the line, past the proud Valhund, the sheepdog. Past the Lappy. Now, beautiful Australian breeds. Beardy and the Border Collie taking up the back. Judge giving a nod to the steward. He knows, we don't.
Giving out to the judge.
They're having a point. Who are they pointing to? Real showman, our judge today, I feel. I'm enjoying it.
This is best puppy.
Our best puppy in group. Oh, he doesn't have the ribbon in his hand. Is he going to move another dog? No? The Shetland Sheepdog will be our best puppy in group. Now, hopefully all of our puppies will stay put for a moment as we find out if that puppy is drawn from the minor or the puppy class.
From the puppy class entry. So,
the puppy class entries will be excused from the ring now, and the best minor puppy will now be decided. The best minor puppy will not need to return for general special stage.
We are leaving around the ring as we leave, and we can applaud you. So if you're a puppy, you might like to step forward and you can move around the ring. Okay, so puppies leading off, please, with that applauding. Okay, a round of applause for the dogs leaving us. These are the puppy class entries for our leaving us.
The puppy class entries head out of the ring. A bit of a traffic jam.
We have the minor puppies.
That happens when you've got little legs in front of big legs. And the minor puppies. The minor puppy in group will now be awarded, but will not need to return for general specials day on Saturday. Our Belgian Shepherd at the front. Our long stock coat German Shepherd dog. Collie Ruff, and he's headed towards the German Shepherd. Will be our best minor puppy in group. Big congratulations to all of the exhibitors today. We've all put in a lot of time and effort, and a big thank you to our wonderful judges from the Netherlands and Malaysia today.
Now we're going to see those beautiful babies. So the babies haven't been judged, coming into the ring first.
They're going to stay with us just a moment as we award the baby puppies in group. Starting off with the Australian Kelpie. I love a Kelpie puppy. Very active though. Can't leave your garden hoses lying around, they'll get chewed. Very active dogs, but that's what they're meant to do. Working dogs. The Australian Kelpie baby puppy getting a round of applause from the audience as it goes around in a triangle. Now this puppy is aged somewhere between 3 and 6 months of age. For our non-exhibiting viewers who may not know, sending the Australian Kelpie out around to the end of the ring as the judge turns to the Australian Shepherd puppy. A lot of the development for the Australian Shepherd, even though they're an Australian breed, did happen in the US, and they're very popular in the USA. For good reason too, beautiful dogs. And the lovely Australian Shepherd baby puppy, aged somewhere between 3 and 6 months, going around in a triangle for the judge to consider the movement of the dog in all directions. And sending the Australian Shepherd puppy around to the end. Do a round of applause from the audience. We have a stumpy-tailed cattle dog baby puppy, which is interesting because we didn't have one eligible for challenge, so we didn't see this breed exhibited in the group. It's lovely to see an Australian stumpy-tailed cattle dog baby puppy ready to go around. A truly Australian breed, as are all our Australian breeds are truly Australian, but you can see how this particular breed would be developed specifically for Australian climates, Australian work. Lovely expression from the stumpy-tailed cattle dog baby puppy as the judge sends the puppy around and considers the border collie baby puppy. The baby puppy saying hello to the judge. Even at a young age, the working dog puppies are very trainable, also very active, so that training very necessary in order to have a pet or companion that is easy to live with. Border collie baby puppy coming to a natural freestand, judge considering the outline of the puppy and sending him or her around to the end of the ring. Oh, he gets ready for his final breed to consider, to examine, before going into the full lineup of baby puppies.
And just to
lovely Briard.
Tomorrow is Group 2, the Terriers.
As I mentioned before, an ancient French breed.
The Will Grand Parade, as there is traditionally on the People's Day. There'll be obedience happening.
Taking the Briard baby puppy around in a triangle, movement away, the side profile movement, and the movement back. Sending the Briard puppy around one last time, he'll join the end of the line, and we'll consider all the breeds now in their numeric order as they were catalogued for the Royal, rather than their alphabetical order. Starting off with our Belgian Shepherd Grand Dame.
So round the applause, please, as they come in. These are all our baby breed winners.
Followed by the Belgian Shepherd.
There we go.
Malinois. Our Welsh Corgi.
Pembroke.
Had to wait till I could see whether it had a tail. I wasn't sure. The German Shepherd dog. And the German Shepherd dog long stock coat on LSC. Coming along behind. Baby puppy, remember, aged between 3 and 6 months, not eligible yet for challenge points.
Finnish Lapland.
The Finnish Lapland.
Australian Kelpie.
Very popular Australian Kelpie. The Australian Shepherd waiting.
Australian Shepherd.
getting a cheer and a round of applause. The Australian stumpy-tailed cattle dog. Moving around. The border collie ready to move. And to finish up the line, the beautiful Briard.
So big round of applause for all our babies, for
baby. Our best baby puppy in group will return for general specials on Saturday and compete against the best baby puppies from the other six groups. Judge making his way down the line. The ring steward, actually that's our advance ambassador, has brought out the prize, ready for the judge to make a decision. Advance, of course, major sponsor of the dog section at EKKA. That's great to have a representative there to assist with the awarding of the prizes. Thank you, Advance. Judge considering who to award the best baby puppy in group. It's heading towards the Australian Shepherd. They've just said border collie, but I'm fairly sure it is the Australian Shepherd. Australian Shepherd will be our best baby.
So, leaning round, please, our other exhibitors, round them, big round of applause, please, as they leave.
Baby puppies exit the ring. A big congratulations to all of the exhibitors today, and a big thank you to our judges who have done a wonderful job. And we'll be back again tomorrow. See you then.
The Australian Capital.